a talented fashion designer from India. Manish Arora was born and raised in Mumbai. He started off studying commerce. When he changed his career goal and opted for fashion designing from National Institute of Fashion Technology, New Delhi. In 1994, Manish not only graduated but also won the Best Student Award.
Fashion designer, why did you start studying commerce?
I didn't know I wanted to be a fashion designer. I was studying commerce because that's what you're supposed to do in Indian families, that you learn business and then you just join your father's business or you do some kind of business of your own. Fashion was very rare. There was only one school at that time. So I did realize I didn't want to do business and I left that halfway, and that's when I went to Delhi to join fashion.
Well, it was, I thought, what the f***, let's just go all the way, you know. And last time, it was my first bridal show, I was trying to be safe. And this time I thought, you know, let's just do it. I thought, let's go back to old days, but I got a Panna Chandra in it. But we really planned. Yeah. Each girl was planned, and it was planned 4 months ago. We knew what each girl was looking. The biggest thing I did today, I thought, which I don't know if people realize, but not a single woman was wearing a scarf or a dupatta. I thought, women don't need that. If a man doesn't wear, why should a woman cover her head? Or why should she be aware of people looking at her? So, in fact, I even gave them transparent chest. I said, I mean, I could only do that much in India, you know? If I had a choice, I would have shown their breasts. But I did as close to that because I thought women are as, especially in our country, they need to be more loud. They don't need to cover their heads. They don't need to feel shy or embarrassed. Because if they do, then men should do the same.
When Manish Arora was asked about his inspiration in an interview, he said that inspiration can come from anything and it is not a problem. The real deal is its execution. It is difficult. The easiest thing is to get inspired and think about an idea. However, how to bring it to life is a challenge.
How would you define your style?
I think fashion for me is a form of art, and just because I am trained in fashion, I use that as to express what's in my mind. It could have been films, it could have been art. So that's why I guess I'm different from the others, because I don't think I'm here to follow the trend. I'd rather make the trend.
Yeah, this is what I really appreciate about you as a designer, is that it comes all from you. You don't try to copy people.
There is so much for me to share that I have in my mind that I don't think I have time to copy. And I don't see much of what's happening. No, I do see what's happening with other people. But I really do have my own voice, and I'm quite happy with it. And I am in this profession because of that. The day I start, the day my work starts looking like the others, then probably I'll stop working. Initially, I was known as the kitsch designer. I was very attracted to things that people will consider useless or just something taken for granted. Images of typical gods or crazy posters from the street. That's how I began, and kind of my work was standing out from there on. Once I started showing in London is when the press started writing about how colorful my work is when I realized that actually my strong point is color. When I started showing internationally, I realized that I have to take my country with me. So I started using ideas which were very generic, taking inspirations like circus, or taking inspirations like space, Mars attack, these kind of different themes. But I will actually come to India and make them in the most exquisite embroideries, which probably I could say today also nobody else in the world can do embroideries like we would do in India. That kind of set me apart, and then people started taking note of me. There I was using the talent of India, but in a vision which was understood by everybody. I was not just, which is the case with a lot of Indian designers, that they would use Indian techniques, but they will as well use Indian history for inspiration, which becomes very ethnic in the end. And that's what doesn't work internationally. People want something now. People want something what's happening around you today. Well, sequence is, I think, something we live with. We don't even think about it as special anymore. You know, our office sequence is considered like a most common ingredient of embroidery. And now, after using it so much, the people who do it, the craftsmen, they have mastered it so much that a lot of times, if you don't see it closely, it looks as good as the printed version. It's as precise. It's part of my first collection, the butterfly dress from my Paris show. And that dress, I remember, it took us about 3.5 to 4 months to create, because each butterfly is hand embroidered. It's something that I can say it's become our identity. I still wanted to reach everybody, and I thought collaboration is the best way to reach people who may not just be in fashion. And it starts from Reebok to Swatch, or to Nivea, or to Nespresso, or Portico bed sheets, or Amrapali jewelry. They're all different kinds. I mean, some of them specifically, Swatch being one of the most colorful ones, which was a global collaboration. The same was with Nespresso. It was a collaboration which was in 250 stores worldwide. It kind of gives you this satisfaction and inspires you to go ahead with many more collaborations in the future.
Manish Arora's style is one that most people can connect with. Not only it is classy, but traditional too. It is funky and chic. Many celebrities and people love his designs.